context. So anyway, what this has become is a really massive metaphor, a really bad action movie, because I filmed the whole thing about a metaphor for the creative process and how an idea can sort of disperse. It doesn't always go as planned. And you've got to work with that. As a result of what happened, there's an artwork that's here the reason it can stand on a plinth is that the sultanas that I didn't eat when I was on the back on the journey, they were on my back. I was carrying 20 kilograms of stuff with me. Sultanas seem like a good thing to take because high energy and backwards visible space. So I got I think about two things. I had a few trek bars to bring me the food, and they were really nice and they kept me going. I made fish and chips in three places along the way, so fish didn't work. And that's something that's the interesting thing I found out was that, like, you know, you can come up with an idea, but the place you really need takes a lot of what can happen. And I really enjoyed going to Weather Springs and fish and chip shops along the route, and most of the time I just walked on the South West Coast Path because it was easier than going on country roads where there's no pavements. So that's that work in a nutshell. Not really sure what it says. The Exeter, what I figured out it was. I don't know what it is now, really. It's a bit of a raw sack, is what I ended up calling it. It's sort of a raw sack, needs a guide with the ink blot test. Where if you're a nutter, you can see crazy things in the ink blot. So this sort of became my sort of raw sack. I don't know what it is. And that inspired the artwork that's over on the far wall, which is a terrible edition that's got two versions of what a raw sack can be. A short link into the Tipex, which is that Simon's still back. Get out of the way, Simon, you're ruining this. Obviously, it's going really well. Yeah. So these are Tipex sculptures. So they're completely made of Tipex, and they've been broken quite a lot since I put them in the gallery space. And yeah, people seem to like touching them. And my thing I'm wondering, people touch the tennis and they take issue with it. They touch the tennis.
Not all people.
So I take that as a compliment, but it sort of talks to me about sort of how an artwork then gets